She denied to sign the waiver for the bank secrecy. She also denied the chance for an executive session. But will you again offer Cassandra Leong the chance for an executive session for her to be able to divulge everything that she knows?
Yes, we will, for the last time. No, if she still will not comply, then that's up to her. We will probably start commenting enough report cases that should be filed against her before any court.
Mm-hmm.
So that's why this is her last chance to speak. No, and the reason why we wanted the waiver is because we wanted to see whether indeed she has money to finance, number mm-hmm. one. Number two, we will also find out and discover where the money came from.
Mm-hmm.
It could probably be a money deposited to her account from a foreign source, or a money deposited to her account in the local source, in the domestic source.
Mm-hmm.
So this information are very vital pieces of information that can help us in our committee report, in our conclusion against her involvement in the illegal pogo hubs.
Mm-hmm. All right. I'd like to jump to a different person this time, Congressman, if you would allow me, on Attorney Harry Roque and his involvement in the issue.
Mm-hmm.
He denied the motion to quash the subpoena for his documents. If he fails to comply when he does appear, does the committee, does the Quad Committee have the power to request agencies to pull out his documents?
That is what we are studying at the moment. He is invoking his constitutional right against self-incrimination.
Mm-hmm.
That's why he doesn't want to submit any document that is being asked of him.
Mm-hmm.
There are decisions from the Supreme Court that the right against self-incrimination only is limited to testimonies, mm-hmm. not to documentary evidences or material evidences.
Mm-hmm.
Therefore, that was our basis in denying his motion to quash.
Mm-hmm.
Because we denied his motion to quash, we will now compel him. And if he fails to submit it before the committee, then it is a contemptible act as far as our rules are concerned. We will cite him in contempt and would impose penalties against Attorney Harry Roque.
Mm-hmm. All right. How important is it for the Quadcom to know of Roque's wealth, and why are we bringing this up, Congressman?
Well, the question really, Rika, is that there was a jump of his wealth in his SALN, or mm-hmm. Statement of Assets, Liabilities, and Net Worth. No, there's also a jump in the finances of a corporation which he organized and registered in 2020 from a mere amount of less than ₱1 million from the first year it was registered and organized. 3 years later, 4 years later, it jumped up to about ₱150 million. So there's a questionable increase in his wealth, no?
Mm-hmm.
Or in the wealth or assets of this corporation. That is why we would like to ask, because there are allegations that he is lawyering for Lucky South 99. And knowing that this is an illegal corporation, he's probably probably involved in an illegal operation of this corporation. So these are the things that we want to discover and unravel when we continue our probe into this illegal pogo operations in the country, Rika.
Mm-hmm. All right. With that, I will let you go. Thank you so much for your time. The House Committee on Dangerous Drugs Chairperson, Congressman Robert Ace Barbers. You have a good afternoon ahead of you, sir. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Rika, and have a good afternoon as well.